Thank you, Mr. Chair. I'm a physician trained in pediatrics and public health, representing the International Physicians for the Prevention of Nuclear War, which is a member of IANSA. We are here to strongly encourage integration of public health personnel and procedures into all aspects of states' national action plans related to the program on small arms and light weapons. We're very happy to have heard several of the earlier speakers echo our concerns. Looking at the original PLA document, there are many points where the public health community can work with other government agencies to reduce the terrible human and monetary costs of illicit gun use. One of them is action-oriented research. For example, we can apply the public health model used to diminish or eradicate other public health crises, such as automobile injuries in the global north, or the recent epidemic of Ebola virus in West Africa. Public health model involves four steps. First, to complete an accurate data collection of the causes and context of gun-related injuries and death. This is not currently being done routinely or universally. Medical and public health communities can play a major role in arranging and conducting this data collection. We need assistance from local and national agencies and policymakers to institute policies and provide the necessary funds. Second, we use data collected to identify risk factors. And third, we then use those risk factors to tailor interventions to specific communities. These interventions need to be evaluated for both effectiveness and feasibility. And so lastly, when interventions are determined to be successful, they should then be implemented on a larger scale. We know how to do this, and we can do it to prevent armed violence and achieve the major goals of the PLA, which are to reduce human suffering, and that of the Secretary General's agenda for disarmament to save lives. As Executive Director of the American Public Health Association has said, the epidemic of intentional gun violence can be reversed with a science-based approach. So we need to implement the science and not let political barriers stand in our way. The World Health Organization definition of health includes a state of complete mental, physical, and social well-being. The right to live and live in that state of well-being free of the fear of physical and mental toll of gun violence should be paramount. Teenagers of Parkland, Florida understand this, and the mothers and fathers of children slain in communities throughout the world understand this. So it's time for you as the policymakers to understand this and do something about it. The World Health Organization has a publication entitled Preventing Violence and Reducing Its Impact, How Development Agencies Can Help. It identifies data collection and research on violence prevention, and especially evaluation, as a top priority. Engaging the health sector in the prevention of armed violence has been recognized as one of the four best buys for donor investment to reduce the consequences of violence. Some recommendations on how states can incorporate public health into their national action plans include: one, healthcare professionals should have representation on national commissions on small arms to help assess the most strategic investments based on highest need. Two, the Ministry of Health certainly should be represented, as should an NGO member of the health community, the daily eyewitnesses of armed violence. Three, the National Commission should liaison with the World Health Organization's violence prevention focal points. They exist in more than 100 countries. Fourth, a national collection of data on gun-related injuries and deaths should be implemented universally. Fifth, data on injuries and deaths should be used to calculate the associated costs of illicit gun violence and misuse. Public health model can then be used to identify and monitor the proposed interventions. And finally,
improvement in the health infrastructure of survivors of armed violence. This can be achieved at the local level by improving communications and coordination among medical providers and social service agencies. Thank you.